Good morning, children. Today we are continuing the chapter 18. Water, a natural resource. We have already started this in the previous week, and today we would be discussing some details of the states of water. You know, water has three states. What are they? Liquid, solid, and gas or steam. Liquid, solid, and steam. Or we can say the solid, liquid, and steam or gas. The solid form of water is ice. You might have seen in different parts of our country during this winter season. Himachal Pradesh, Kashmir, many parts of our Bengal, some Darjeeling and other areas. You might have seen that the water frozen into ice. So ice is the solid form of water. At what degree Celsius the water freezes into ice? 0 degree and below that. 0 degree and below 0 degree, the water start becoming ice. So water freezes into ice 0 degree onward below. Okay. So we can say, you can understand that first point. Now, this ice can melt. This ice can melt above 0 degree Celsius. 0 degree Celsius, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 100. The ice can melt into water. Okay, so above 0 degree Celsius, the ice can melt into water, and water is the liquid form of the liquid form, and we can see that liquid form, you can see 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius the water can be, ice can melt. So ice can melt right from 0 degree and above to up to 100 degree Celsius. So we can see the second part, water in the liquid form, and is formed from the ice above 0 degree Celsius to Celsius. Now the water again boil. Once the water is formed, you can take water in the vessel, and in the form you might have seen your mummy cooking food, and after some time of boiling or heating the water start boiling. So we can understand that boiling, here you can write boiling. While heating the water, water can be converted to the steam. So this process of boiling the water, what is the boiling temperature? 100 degree Celsius. Above 100 degree and above 100 degree Celsius, water boil. So water boil above 100 degree Celsius. So this is what is called steam or gas. So ice become water, water into steam. These are the three states of water: ice, water, and steam. At what temperature the ice is formed? Ice is formed below 0 degree Celsius. 0 degree and below that. So again, that can be converted into water by melting. That is from 0 degree to 100 degree Celsius. Water can be formed from the ice. Again, boiling in our form. When the water is boiled, it can become steam or gas. That is, above 100 degree Celsius, water becomes steam or gas. You got it. Now, second question. What is the melting point and the freezing point of water 0 degree Celsius? And you can see, below the 0 degree Celsius is the freezing point of the water. 0 degree and below that. 0 degree and below that. 0 degree and below that is the freezing point of water, that becomes ice. And 0 degree above. 0 degree above. So how we will write here? Below 0 degree, we are writing like this. Below 0 degree. Below 0 degree. And above 0 degree, we can write like this. Okay, so below 0 degree Celsius, the water can become above 0 degree Celsius, above 0 degree Celsius, you can see the water, water become, water will start, ice start melting. Below 0 degree, water become ice, and above 0 degree, water melt. Means ice melt into water. Okay? Now, boiling point, the third point. Boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. Because we have written here 100 degrees Celsius is the boiling point of water. When your mummy boil the water for putting rice or cooking purpose, you can see that the water will not boil right from the beginning. After some time, when the temperature increases, you can use a thermometer. Okay, you can use a thermometer and you can measure the temperature. You find out that at around 100 degrees Celsius, the water start boiling and become steam or gas. So boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. When steam is cooled, it changes into water. So when the steam is cooled, for example, during a sunny day, the water from the water bodies like river, lakes and ocean get evaporated and become steam. Okay, because water get evaporated in higher temperature, and now this water steam goes up in the space and get cooled down. This cooling process is called condensation. So when steam is cooled, it changes back to water and come down as rain. So rain formation is very very important this chapter. Condensation. So water condenses to form rain. You got it? That much? Okay. Thank you.